Hello, welcome. Today is part two of life in the living and grow room. It's going to be mostly felon abscess, some cattleya, one cattleya, sophronitis, telomnia, and then cichlea, paphiopedilum, dendrobium. I was thinking I will take them out and put them on the table and have a closer look at them. Right, Dad. Denise from Denise Orchids Paradise asked me what lights I use. And this is the lights I use. It is the Gemma LED 12 watts spotlight. The old generation, there's a new generation with a chip on board now. These are different colored LEDs, as you can see in the reflection here. There, but that is the lights I use. I really love them. There is a new generation. One day I will try them out, but they're about 50 euros a piece, so that's quite a lot. Well, let's take them off and have a look at them. So we got them all from the wall and onto the table. Well, let's have a close look. I'll try to make it a fast one. This is the Cattleya Durigon, of the Cattleya Pintada Rosada, crossed with Cattleya Leopoldia Escura Pintada. It's doing a flush of roots at the moment. There's one, there's one, there's one. There in the middle, swan starting. So it seems to be feeling reasonably happy. This is the Sophronitis Brevipedunculata, yes. The latest growth is moving, but I don't know what it's doing. It's not doing anything much yet at the moment. Then I'll do this one first. The Phalaenopsis Brother Glory LF is growing a nice leaf, and that looks like the start of a spike. I haven't got it in bloom, but I haven't even got it a year for now, so it took a long time to start growing leaves, but it seems to be happy. Put this aside. Then my new Telomnia peach. Look at the spike, it's growing on nicely. There's a bit of root growth, nothing much further with this one. Quick question. Can I mount this in this state with the spike growing without risking blasting the spike? Because I can't really judge if it's still wet or not. But anyway, please let me know if you know the answer. I would really appreciate it. Then another spike on my Phalaenopsis Venus. That's Equestris crossed with Lindeni. Which is, Equestris seems should be a very easy growing orchid, and the Lindeni is one of the coolest growing orchids, Phalaenopsis, if I am correct. Beautiful speckling on the leaves. There is a very nice rating system if the lighting is good on this one. Look, when it's getting too little light, no freckles, not one, none so ever. Here it had good light. It had a moment with a bit worse light, and now it's back in the good light, and the freckling is back. And there's a spike growing. And there is root growth. It's doing everything at once. It's quite thirsty for such a small plant, but it's looking good. Yes. Next, another fell. It's Phalaenopsis, Timothy Christopher. Timothy Christopher, and then a number from Orchids Deluxe. It was in bloom, I think, in May when I just started the channel. Then it grew this leaf. And now, at the end of the season, dun, 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 another spike. Yes, another spike. Any more? No, but I'm not greedy. One spike is enough. Look at that. Very nice. So the fells are doing very well. Let's do something different. Oh. And I didn't mean knocking you over, but here we go. I'm sorry for that. Didn't mean to hurt your head. This is my only Paphiopedilum I got left. I donated the two other ones, the Pinocchio and the Morier Green, to a fellow beekeeper / orchid. Well, she's not an addict, but she likes them. But this is my only one left. My Paphiopedilum primulinum. It's growing a nice new leaf. And this is a pot full of roots. This is a... There's a nice root tip. Here are nice new fresh root tips. This is a very nice, very good root grower. I wish it would grow faster on the leaves. And I really would like it for it to spike. It's a sequential bloomer. It's quite a highlight orchid, as for Paphiopedilums go. I'll put this one at the back. My Phalaenopsis, Sweet Memory, Leodoro. Look at those roots. Do you think this plant is happy? I think it really is. It really is happy. It's root growth everywhere. It grew a nice, beautiful leaf last year. Yeah, before it started spiking. And then now it's growing this nice and beautiful leaf. And I'm getting muddled up with the rest. Look at that. Nice and shiny broad leaf. It might even be color-wise and shininess-wise. It's not a word, but I just made it up. It might be the best looking leaf on it. But look at those roots. It's really having fun. And then my Encyclia Colichera. Finally, the bulb is plumping up again. It has roots in a pot, which are branching at the moment. They are not very brilliant, but they start. Recently, they started hydrating the bulb again, and the new growth is doing a flush of roots, which all go skywards. Yeah. Which I'm not very fond of, but yeah, what to do with it? Well, and the bulb is plumping up, so it seems to be happy. It's such a purplish tinge in the leaf, which seems to be perfect if I understand correctly. Then my Dendrobium Norotokunaga crossed with Aberrance, crossed back to Aberrance, which makes it 75% Aberrance. These are the two growths it grew this season. And this one at the beginning of the season, it's a bit stunted. But I really do hope it's gonna spike soon. I don't know if it needs extra care for it to spike. It started recently, it started a new growth around here. But that's aborting, it's not doing well. It should look great on a mount. Well, maybe we should do that. Nice pot full of roots, growing root tips. Things to think about. I'm gonna rearrange a bit. This is my Phalaenopsis spatii red sun. This is its third leaf, and when the third bloom, and when the third bloom opened, this bloom collapsed. But for a moment it had three colors on one spike. This one's very yellow. It's even more yellow in real than the camera picks up. This one is lesser yellow. There's a black thingy on it. This is with little yellow, more white, and the other bloom, it was pure white with a bit of the freckling. That's in here too. Beautiful blooms. They smell quite soapy. And look at that. Nice root growth. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. And then it grew this spike, and it's in bloom for quite a while already. It's, yeah, might be a couple of months. This is the latest bloom. But yeah, it's doing great, I think. It seems to be doing great. Oh, 11 minutes already. And that'll be more than when you watch now, because there's an extra bit to it. But this is my last. Is this the last one? This is the last one, so I'll make it quick. My Dorytenopsis Isshin Sesame, or as it's called, Phalaenopsis Isshin Sesame nowadays. It is finally growing some new roots. It's was in bloom for quite a long time, from beginning this year right into spring. It's an old leaf dying back. But there's no new root of leaf growth yet. But it's stalled a bit, and I think it's getting its act together. It's doing roots now, so it can hydrate better, or with fresh roots is always better. So it will pick up, but it's a bit slow at the moment. Well, thanks for watching. See you next time. That could be an unboxing, but it's gonna be an unboxing with a difference. But it might be another video too. We'll see. Well, I'll know before you'll know, but you'll know then. I'll see you next time. Hope to see you soon. Houdoe.